give me an idea of what you do during an audit. Now, my impression was, like, do you put this thing out to bid with other trash companies in that area where I'm working? I think one time, because I had a company do this for me on many of my properties, and they also had something to do with the frequency and with the size of the dumpster, all those types of things. I think they took into consideration. How do you do it?
So think about what we do in terms of two broad, what I call broad savings buckets. The first bucket is going to be service improvements. And a service improvement would be, you have a property, you have 2 8-yard dumpsters that go 5 times a week. They go 3 times a week, whatever they go. We would analyze that based on a model we've developed. So we service 4 or 5 industries. Multifamily is by far the largest, but we have a model we've developed as part of that analysis that shows your number of units and the number of residencies and the occupancy rate, and tells us how many yards of trash that property should be generating. It's imperfect. It's just part of the equation. We don't use that as a lockstep, a final be all. And so sometimes you've got a community dump situation. You know, we've all had those. So where you're getting extra trash from out people that don't even live on your premises. And so we look at that and we determine, are your container sizes accurate? Is the frequency level accurate? Is it going to the best place? And on down the list it goes. Do you have valet or door-to-door service? Can that be tweaked? Would it make sense to add that? So these are all things that we look at, and then we would present those to you. And again, you would have the final say. The second broad bucket is when we would actually look at that agreement from Waste Management, Republic, Waste Pro, whatever the hauler is in your area. And we would look at the terms that you have in place. Is the pricing in line with what the market is bearing? We cannot wave a magic wand and make that agreement disappear. And so we do have to work under the constraints of the agreement you have in place. And so we would just determine, are there opportunities? Because we work with these haulers over and over and over again, oftentimes we have a little better rate of success in getting to renegotiate it prior to the expiration. But again, they're under no obligation. I mean, they can tell us to go play in traffic if they want. Yeah. And if that's the case, we would just notate it. We would put it back out to bid when the time comes, assuming you're in a market where there are multiple haulers available.